The Great Fog of London, 1952, Act of God. In December 1952, London was plunged into a nightmare. An ordinary winter fog became one of the deadliest environmental disasters in British history. Post-war London was a city still rebuilding. Bomb sites scarred the landscape, homes were cold and damp, and life was hard. Coal was at the heart of daily survival. It warmed living rooms, powered factories, and lit the streets. But every fire sent smoke into the air, and with millions of chimneys across the capital, the sky was already heavy with pollution. Fog was nothing new to Londoners. To some, it even felt romantic, part of the city's character. On 5th December 1952, the fog rolled in. At first, people thought little of it. But soon, the city was paralyzed. Visibility dropped to just a few meters. Buses and cars crawled through the streets. Some abandoned altogether. People stumbled home, unable to see even their own feet. Theaters closed, cinemas shut their doors, and even ambulances were forced off the roads. London had ground to a halt. Then came the human cost. The smoke seeped into lungs deep and deadly. Hospitals filled with patients struggling to breathe.
Fog of London has been the chief topic in the south of Britain. Its result being, of course, a great hold-up and vast inconvenience for millions. Traffic in London was completely at a standstill on many occasions. In fact, the fog was the worst on record for many a year.
Children, the elderly, and those with weak hearts suffered the most. At first, officials estimated around 4,000 deaths. Later studies showed the true number was about 12,000. This was no ordinary fog. It was a silent killer. At the time, the government was slow to respond. Many brushed it off as just another winter fog, something Londoners had always endured. But public anger grew, and the disaster couldn't be ignored. The Great Smog changed Britain forever. In 1956, the Clean Air Act was introduced. It was the first step towards modern environmental laws, a direct legacy of those dark December days. Today, the Great Smog of 1952 is remembered as a turning point, a chilling reminder that the air we breathe can never be taken for granted. And it leaves us with a question. Have we truly learned the lessons of the past, or are we still choking on history's mistakes?
The Conservative and National Liberal parties set in the forefront of their policy a basic standard.